Right. Now, from today's lecture, we will start with the third chapter. It is the electrical energy based non-conventional machining flow. Just we go through the syllabus. We have 3 hours lecture. For practical, there will be oral examination. So I appeal all the students to be present for all lectures so that you are getting a good marks in oral. Right? As far as our first section is to be concerned, we have covered overview of non-conventional processes, where we discuss about the need, classification, comparison of non-conventional machining process against conventional machining process, and we are giving the brief review of all the techniques that we have studied under the subject. Then we dealing with the mechanical energy based process, where we are study abrasive jet machining, water jet machining, abrasive water jet machining, and ultrasonic machining in terms of their working principle, equipment use, what are the different process parameter, its effect on metal remove rate, and various applications of this process. Now, from today we are starting with the third unit, that is the electrical energy based process, where you are dealing with the electric discharge machining and a wire cut EDM, that is the wire cut electric discharge machining. We have to study its working principle, what are the equipment used in the EDM and wire cut EDM, which are the different process parameters, those are affecting the performance of these two processes, what is the MRR, that is the metal remove rate, what is the electrode, or it also called as a tool in case of EDM, what is the concept of a tool wear, what is the concept of a dielectric flushing, we have to study, and at the last we will discuss about the application of these two processes. Forgetting, this will be the content for the third chapter. Write down unit number 3, electrical energy based process. The content of this chapter, that is the electric discharge machining, that is the EDM, and it's one of the another application. Instead of electrode, if you are using wire as an electrode instead of a rod, then that will be wire cut EDM. We have to study its working principle, equipment use, parameter, effect of parameter on metal remove rate, what is the electrode wear or tool wear, what is the concept of a dielectric flushing, and the application. I write this content and chapter name. Okay. Now, from today, we are starting with the first of the machining, which is based on electric energy. That is the electric discharge machining, EDM. Write down the name, EDM. Electric discharge machining. Now, what is this electric discharge machine? It is a combination of electrical and thermal energy. Means we are generating the heat energy by consuming the electrical energy, and that heat energy is utilized to remove the material from the workpiece. So that this EDM is an electrothermal, non-conventional, or it may be called as a non-traditional, or it may be called as an advanced machining process, where electric energy is utilized to generate the electric spark by maintaining a sufficient distance between the workpiece and the electrode, we are able to generate this spark. The material removal, it will be carried out because of thermal energy of this spark, when spark is to be generated, to generate the spark, we have to apply the voltage against the electrode and the workpiece. It is near about 250 volt voltage, and that will create the current of more than 100 ampere, and that will generate the heat of a temperature of 10,000 degree centigrade. And at that much amount of heat due to the spark, the provision of the process of material removal, it will be carried out. In case of this electric discharge machine, the work material, it must be an electrical conductive one, and any kind of the hard material can be easily machined by using this electric discharge machine. This will be the introduction regarding this our electric discharge machine. Now read this introduction and write some points from this introduction. If anybody is outside this meeting, please text me a message. I think everyone is now admitted in this class. Right? Now today's strength is improved. Thank you. Please be remain with the same spirit for all the lectures, for all the days, right? That is the one small expectation from you people. Okay, this is a idiom. I repeat, because many number of students are outside this Google Meet lecture. So I will repeat. Electric discharge machining, it is one of the form of electrical energy based non-conventional or non-traditional machining process, where we are using the electrical energy in order to generate an electrical spark, and that electrical spark, it will generate the high amount of heat up to a temperature 10,000 degree centigrade, and whatever the material is to be removed from the surface of the workpiece, it is due to the heat energy or thermal energy of the spark. But in case of electric discharge machining, you must have to use the work material which is a electrically conductive one. By using this idiom, we can easily machine any kind of the hard material. Whenever spark that will be takes place between the small gap between electrode and the workpiece, small amount of material is to be removed from each contact. the relaxation circuit was proposed in which electrodes are immersed in a dielectric fluid like kerosene and are connected to the capacitor. Means in order to maintain a sufficient heat or in order to cool the electrode and the workpiece at that spark gap, we have to provide certain relaxation circuit and that will be connected to the capacitor. Means in case of electric discharge machine, whatever the material is to be removed because of the heat energy of the spark, and that heat energy of the spark, it will melt or vaporize the material due to the high temperature of the spark, and the material is to be removed at a small gap between tool and the workpiece, and to maintain a temperature within a range, we may use the relaxation circuit which will utilize the capacitor. Now this will be the diagram, schematic diagram of electric discharge machine using relaxation circuits. Here this will our workpiece. This is an tool, or it also called as an electrode. Ready? Now the workpiece, it will be always provided with the positive supply of the battery. So workpiece, it will act as an anode. Always keep in mind, positive terminal of the battery voltage, it will be always connected to the workpiece, and the negative terminal, it is always connected to the tool or. And in order to maintain the temperature during this process, we are providing this capacitor, right, in parallel to this positive and negative terminal. Also, it is provided with a small capacity of a resistor, right? So this circuit is called as a relaxation circuit. We are not directly given negative, positive supply to the workpiece and negative supply to the tool. Also, we are provided one resistor and one capacitor within this circuit, right? So this will be the supply voltage, and we see that will be a capacitor voltage. It will be applied against the tool and the workpiece. Now, whatever the connection, it will be formed. This will be the workpiece. It is having positive terminal. This will be the tool, which is having a negative terminal. Right, when high voltage is to be applied across this tool and the workpiece, high current is generated, and when you are maintaining a sufficient gap between the tool and the workpiece, sparking that will generate, right, high amperage current, it will start to spark. And why it is happening? Because of the ions transformation through this dielectric fluid molecule. आणि याच्यामधून काय पास करतो आपण ह्या गॅप मधून? डाय इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लुइड. इट विल बी पेट्रोलियम बेस, इट विल बी केरोसिन, पॅराफाइन, राईट? दॅट फ्लुइड विच आर अलाउड टू पास थ्रू द गॅप बिटवीन टूल अँड द वर्क पीस, अँड दॅट डाय इलेक्ट्रिक फ्लुइड इज अ नॉट कंडक्टिव्ह मीडियम, नॉन कंडक्टिव्ह मीडियम. इट विल फ्लश आउट वॉट एवर द मटेरियल इज टू बी रिमूव्ह बाय द ऍक्शन ऑफ द स्पार्किंग. ऍज स्पार्क इज प्रोड्यूस, thousand of spark is to be produced within a fraction of minutes. So more amount of heat is generated, and by using this heat we can remove the material. Large amount of material is to be removed from the workpiece, and very small amount of material is to be removed from the tool or electrode also, and that will be happen because of a transformation of the ions, right? From ions, it will be moved toward the cathode, and molecules, it will be moved toward the anode. In this way, ion and electrons, it will be moved from anode to cathode and cathode to anode, so that circuit, it will be completed. So this will be the schematic diagram of EDM by using a relaxation circuit. You may draw this diagram. because of a high electric fluid, a high electric voltage against this workpiece, and the that will act as an anode, and tool that will act as a cathode. The ions, it will be moved toward the cathode, and electrons that will be moved toward the anode, and metal removal process is to be carried out because of a high temperature of the wire. Is it over? How sparking it will be taken here? We are applying DC source. Positive terminal always connected to the workpiece, and negative terminal it will be connected to the electrode or the tool. So whatever the workpiece, it will be act as anode, and the electrode it will be act as a cathode. When you are maintaining a sufficient distance in between these two, tool and the workpiece, the spark it will be generated because of the movement of the molecules and breakdown of the molecule. Whatever the ion, it will be moved, positive ions, it will be moved toward the cathode. And whatever the electrons that will be emitted by the cathode, that will, those are having a negative charge, and that are attracted toward the anode. And the transfer of this ion and electron, it will be because of this dielectric fluid atom. It will carry out the transformation of this ion and electron. As ions are moving toward the cathodes and electrons are moving toward the anode, because of that sparking it will be initiated, and that spark is generating having a very high heat or high thermal energy, and that will be in a range of near about 10,000 degrees centigrade. So this will be the process of a sparking. It will be takes place between anode and cathode in a presence of a dielectric fluid atom. And this dielectric fluid atom, those are mainly a petroleum products like a paraffin, kerosene, right? And they are used, they act as an insulator, and they are not conductive of the electricity, right? Dielectric fluid. But whatever the material used for the workpiece, it must be electrically conductive material. Draw this diagram also. Why you are written your roll number in chat box? That will be not considered as attendance. When I am telling you to write your roll number, at that particular time, attendance it will be considered. Okay, next. Working of this electric discharge machining process, right? As we know, as we already discussed, that we are applying certain voltage across the tool and the workpiece, where tool is acting as a cathode, because negative terminal of the battery, it will be connected to the tool or electrode, so it will be act as a cathode, and positive terminal of the DC supply, it will be connected to the workpiece and which will be electrically conductive one, right? And that will be act as an anode. When a sufficient gap, it will be maintained between electrode and the workpiece, that is called as the IEG, that is the internal electrode gap. Like in abrasive machining, we nozzle tip distance, we deal about the nozzle tip distance or stand up distance. Likewise, in electrode discharge machining, that is the IEG, internal electrode gap, right? We have to maintain within a certain range of a certain microns or 0.005 mm within this range. So that will create a certain kind of ionized column between tool and the workpiece. And this workpiece and tool both are immersed in a dielectric fluid medium for the transformation of the ions or electrons. From ions, it will be moved from anode to cathode, and electrons, it will be moved from cathode to ion. So that will create this ionized column, and it will help to remove the material from the workpiece in a large quantity. It will be shown by the crater on a workpiece, and a small amount of material may be removed from the tool. It will depend on the hardness of that tool. So it will be again shown by this crater. And we are deliberately producing certain spark between this tool and the workpiece in order to carry out localized heating at a particular area. And by creating that spark, large amount of heat, it will be generated, and the temperature that will be achieved in a range of 10,000 degrees centigrade, which will help to melting and vaporizing of the material. And whatever the gap between the tool and the workpiece, it is a few hundred microns, right? So 0.005 microns, that much small gap is maintained, and that will be essential to produce the spark between tool and the workpiece, right? And we are providing a dielectric fluid between this gap between tool and the workpiece in order to flush out whatever the material is to be removed from the workpiece and the tool. It must be carried out from this location, otherwise it will stop this process of a sparking. For that purpose, dielectric fluid, it will always help to flush out this removed material from the workpiece and the tool. Are you getting working principle of this electric discharge machine? Draw this diagram. Okay, next. Whatever we discuss in last slide, it will be represented on this slide. Breakdown of the dielectric fluid. It will be takes place between two electrodes, that is a tool and the workpiece, right? One electrode, it will be act as a tool, and another electrode, it will be act as a workpiece. Dielectric ionization, where molecules, electron from the cathode and the that will collide with the molecules of this deionized fluid. It will split into the ions and a electron, right? Ions that will move towards the cathode and electrons that will be moved towards the anode. These electrons hit the cathode and ion that will hit the anode. Due to the movement of these ions and electrons to the cathode and anode, they liberate their kinetic energy and they will produce the heat on cathode that will be in less amount. Cathode is nothing but the tool or electrode, and more heat is to be generated or liberated at the anode, that is a workpiece. So more amount of material is to be removed from the workpiece. That heat, it will help to melt or even vaporize a small part of the cathode and anode. So in case of electric discharge machining, by generating the spark, by maintaining a sufficient distance between tool and the workpiece, we are able to remove the material by melting or vaporizing in a small portion. That will be feasible by using the electric discharge machine. You may read this slide, so you are able to visualize how this electric discharge machining process is to be carried out by using the spark. And that spark, how it will be utilized to remove the material from the workpiece. Okay, next. Now, in first section or first part, we are dealing with the introduction of a electric discharge machining, then how spark is to be generated, then which type of circuit it is utilized to maintain a sufficient temperature, and the working principle of the electric discharge. In second part, we are focusing on electric discharge system, which are the different elements those are used in electric discharge system. Also, the concept of the dielectric flashing, what is the electrode, which type of the electrode we are using, and the wear of this electrode, how it will be nomenclature, it will be considered under this second part. If we are considering electric discharge machining system, this will be the electric machining chamber, right? We are providing spark on the workpiece, which will be mounted on a workpiece holding system. This electric discharge machining chamber, it is also provided with a certain kind of a servo motor mechanism in order to produce, in order to maintain a constant gap between a tool and the workpiece. Also, it is provided with a certain dielectric fluid supply medium in order to flush out the material which is removed during the electric discharge machining. No doubt we require a certain kind of electric energy, and that will be supplied by using the power source. It may be a current, right? And certain amount of open voltage, it will be maintained at this gap between the electrode and the workpiece. So any kind of electric discharge machining, it will require a power supply, then constant mechanism of servo by using the servo motor, workpiece holding device in order to hold the workpiece, and dielectric fluid system in order to flush out the removed material from the workpiece. So EDM machine tool has four major elements: power supply, dielectric system, servo system, tool electrode, tool, or it also called as a electrode, and workpiece. You may draw this block diagram so that we can explain each element of this EDM machine in detail. Now, dielectric system, this part, dielectric system, we are dealing with this. The purpose, yes? Yes, Ajinkya, any problem? Ajinkya Dado? Mute yourself then.
No, sir. Okay.
Now time is up 11:38. Write down the attendance. Write down your roll number in chat box for the attendance purpose. 11:38 to 11:40. That timing it will be considered for the attendance. Harshal left the meeting. Okay, 71 is absent. Harshal, are you there? I think network problem is this. Okay, no issue. we are dealing with this dielectric system that will supply the dielectric fluid, which will may be a certain petrochemical based product, and it will be non-conductive of electricity, or it will act as an insulating material also in order to maintain the heat, right? And it will, whatever the molecules of this dielectric fluid, it will be when strike with the ions, and that will produce certain kinds of the electrons, and the ions are moving toward the cathode and electrons are moving toward the anode. Because of that movement, within a fraction of a second, that will be termed as a spark. The dielectric system, it consists of a certain kind of a fluid, a reservoir, filter, pump, and delivery device. The commonly used dielectric fluid, it will be a paraffin oil, kerosene, certain kind of the lubricating oil, transformer oil, and we may use the deionized water also as an dielectric. When you are using a dielectric fluid, a good dielectric fluid should have certain properties, like it must have a high dielectric strength. It will take a minimum time for the breakdown. It will deionize the gap immediately when spark is to be occurred. Also, it will have high degree of fluidity. If you are using deionized water as a dielectric fluid, it will give the higher rate of material removal, and it will more effective cooling medium as compared to the another type of the dielectric fluid, like a transformer oil, paraffin oil, or kerosene. The filtration of the dielectric fluid before recirculation, it will be required to maintain fixed dielectric strength. As we are recirculating this dielectric fluid through that process, there will be essentiality to filter out that dielectric fluid in order to remove the material which will be removed from the workpiece or tool. Whatever the material is to be removed, that will be filtered if you are recirculating the dielectric fluid in a same machining process. Because if you are not filtering that dielectric fluid, it will reduce the dielectric strength of the dielectric fluid. Because a good dielectric fluid, it must have to maintain high dielectric strength. Right? This will be the dielectric system. It consists of, no doubt, reservoir. It is filled with the dielectric fluid in order to filter out the metallic material which will be removed during the process. We require the filter to supply that dielectric fluid from the reservoir to the machining gap. We require the pump and certain kind of the delivery devices in order to carry out that the flushing operation at the gap between the tool and the workpiece, where we can remove the material or flush out that removed material from the workpiece and the tool. So these are the components of the dielectric system, and these would be the commonly used dielectric fluid. And dielectric fluid must have certain properties. If you are using deionized water as a dielectric fluid, it will give these benefits, and filtration of a dielectric, it will be essential in order to maintain the high dielectric strength of that medium. Write down these points of a dielectric system. Okay, next. There are certain methods of dielectric flushing. Means we are providing the dielectric fluid in order to clean up whatever the material is to be removed by the process of electric discharge machine. The first method, that is the suction through electrode. Means we are supplying the dielectric fluid from the sides of the electrode and it will be sucked at the center of the electrode or tube. Second, suction through the workpiece. We are supplying the dielectric fluid from the sides of this tool and it will be sucked from the center of the workpiece. Three, pressure through electrode. Means we are supplying the dielectric fluid with the pressure through the electrode and it will be thrown outside from the side of the electrode. Pressure through workpiece. We are supplying pressurized fluid from the center of the workpiece and that will be flushed out from the sides of the tool. Jet flushing means we are supplying the jet nozzle and through that nozzle we are supplying high velocity dielectric fluid at the gap between tool and the workpiece. So it will flush out whatever the material removed during this machining process. And periodic cycling of the electrode means we are supplying the dielectric fluid naturally by natural flow, but we are vibrating this electrode in cyclic manner, periodic cycling manner. So these are the certain methods of flushing by dielectric fluid. So write down the heading, method for dielectric flushing, and draw the six diagram neatly. Okay, this will be the some description related with this slide. Ineffective flush, it will result with the stagnation of a dielectric fluid and built up machining residues which apart from low material removal rate and poor surface finish which lead to short circuit and arcs. Here, if you are not providing the sufficient flushing by using the dielectric fluid, that will result in a stagnation of the dielectric system, and certain machining residues that will be present on the workpiece and the tool also, and which will result in a less amount of material removal, that is a low material removal rate, and which will give poor surface finish, and because of that there will be possibility of a generation of the arc is different and spark is different here, and because of this arc that will be caused because of the short circuit. If any debris, it will be present in a inner electrode gap, means gap between the tool or electrode and the workpiece, that will result, it will produce the breach in the inner electrode gap, and that will yield more number of arc, and such kind of the arc can be eliminated by proper filtration of the dielectric fluid as well as the appropriate flushing of this gap between electrode and the tool. So in order to avoid this arc, you have to properly flush the gap between the electrode or tool and workpiece. Also you can properly filtrate the dielectric, use the dielectric fluid, right? The increase in the pollution of the dielectric, it will result in a decrease in a breakdown in density of the field. Means increase in the pollution of a dielectric, means if dielectric fluid contains more amount of a material which will be removed from the anode and the cathode, that is the tool and the workpiece, so you must have to filter that removed metal particles. So this dielectric fluid, it will be clean, or it will be a not polluted one. If it will contain certain amount of the material which will be removed from the workpiece or the tool, that polluted dielectric fluid, it will affect the performance of the process. It may result breakdown of the intensity of the power field. For that purpose, as we studied different method of the dielectric flushing, out of which jet flushing is a less effective. Hence, it should be used only when none of other method can be used due to tool and workpiece configuration. At that time only, you can use the jet flushing. Otherwise, you can implement any other five methods that will give the better result. In case of a dielectric fluid which is inflammable, the workpiece should always be immersed in a dielectric fluid in order to minimize the chances of getting a fire during the accident. So when you are using dielectric fluid which will be inflammable in its property, at that time we can immerse the workpiece in a dielectric in order to minimize the possibility of accidental fire. So this will be the slide which will give insight regarding the what is the dielectric fluid or dielectric fluid supplying mechanism, what are the different methods of a dielectric flushing, and how this dielectric flushing is essential in order to increase the material removal rate and surface finish. Also, it will help to decrease the breakdown intensity, and which method is suitable for a commonly used electric discharge machining. When this jet flushing method is to be used, and in case of an inflammable dielectric fluid, we can dip the workpiece in a dielectric fluid also. The second element, that is the electrode. electrode, it will be a tool, palm shaped tool. It will be act as an electrode. The tool electrode in EDM is the mean of providing electric energy to the work material. Means through the electrode we can supply the electric energy to the work piece. That will be the one kind of a mean to transfer the electric energy to the work piece. Whatever the machining accuracy of this electric discharge machining, it will be depend on a form stability of the tool. Whatever the shape of that tool, it will be must remain constant throughout the operation under the several electrical and flushing stress conditions. Means there should not be wearing out of the electrode. That will be not accepted during this EDM process. The electrode must have certain desirable properties, like it must be easily machined to any kind of the shape. It must have low wear rate. It must be have hard, good conductor of the heat and electricity, and no doubt it must be cheap and easily available one. These are the certain desired properties of the electrode, and which kind of the material is to be used for the electrode or tool. In case of a EDM, we may use the graphite, copper, brass, copper tungsten, cast alumina, copper boron, and silver tungsten. These are the material. Those are used as an electrode or tool in case of EDM, depending upon the material of the workpiece. So this will be the information regarding the electrode, which will be act as a tool in case of electric discharge. Write down some points that will be mentioned in this slide regarding the electrode. Is anybody have any query regarding this EDM machining? Very nice strength today, 2041. Good. If number of students are there, then we also enjoy the teaching. If student strength is 17-18, we prepare more and less number of students are there, then that will affect the performance of teacher also. So be present in all lectures for overall schedule lectures, right? With this we may stop over here. If anybody have any doubt regarding this initial part of this EDM machining, please feel free to ask me through chat box or by unmuting yourself. Anybody have any problem? Yes, Harshal. Harshal is there. Unmute yourself. Sanket. Sanket is there. Shirsat.
Sir.
Okay. Have you understood the working of the EDM?
Yes, sir.
Okay. With this, I think we will stop over here. Next lecture of PE might be given to me by Utpat sir, not confirmed. If possible, I will get that lecture, I will cover the remaining part. Right? With this, we will stop over here. Thank you. Thank you very much.